Hello, I'm ObiXToyCat, and welcome back to another feature preview. Feature previews are a weekly series I run on my channel where I show you features that are going to be included within the next big update for Minecraft Xbox and Minecraft PlayStation. We don't know entirely what this update will be called, although it's likely it's going to be called Title Update 25, but what we do know is that 4J are giving us at least one new feature announcement each week, and I figure it's pretty cool that I can use PC gameplay and show you exactly how these features work before they come out on the console, so you can be prepared and you can know exactly what's going on. So please do like the video if you do like it. It helps out the channel a lot, and let's know you do like it. And if you can't tell already, what we're going to be covering today is the book and Quill. This is one of the most interesting inclusions for the console because it is something that 4J said they didn't want to include on the consoles because they said it just wouldn't work because of the fact that, you know, you don't want to type a massive book on the console, but that is changing now, and that is quite interesting in itself. But let's talk about the feature itself because there are quite a few interesting things to be learned about this particular thing. So let's go into these one by one, I guess. So let's start with exactly how it's different to a regular book, just in case you aren't familiar. So I am using PC gameplay, like I mentioned, but yeah, this is a regular book just here. This is a book and quill. The book and quill is different because with a book and quill, you can actually write inside it. But first of all, how do you craft a book and quill? Because, you know, this is something that's going to be important if you want to use these. Basically, what you want to do is you want to have like books, ink, and then feathers. In case you are playing on PC or you're going to be using manual crafting, you're going to need to know this. And basically, you can craft them like this, and then you get books and quills. So you actually will need multiple ones of these. So I recommend if you want to get lots of these, stockpile this stuff now, because you do for some things, you do want to have lots of books and quills, but I'll come into that later. So let's first of all cover exactly how a book and quill works. So when you use the book and quill, what it does is it opens up this page right here. It also pauses the game if you're playing single player, and then it gives you the opportunity to write here. So if you're on a console, it's going to of course come up with the menu where it's like, okay, so now you type manually with your controller. It will be a very slow thing to be like H, and then you scroll over to the X, and then you scroll to whatever. But yeah, if you have any form of other thing, you can just type in like, welcome to my server, rules, don't grief, and then, I don't know, follow at IBXToyCat. That's a solid rule. But yeah, basically, you know, you write in your book, and then that's that. So the cool thing about books is it's not just a lot of signs in one. So this is the equivalent of, like, 5 signs on one page, but the books, as well as being able to contain 256 characters on page, which is much more than a sign, they also have multiple pages. So each page can be something different, like currency. The currency is gold. And you can do this for each page. You can write something new, brand new. And this is cool for a bunch of reasons. Not only because you can write, like, a story on each page if you want to. You can just ignore pages if you want to go all the way up to the max. But yeah, like, you can write a story on each page you want to. You can write rules on each page as well as, like, you know, general, like, white guidelines. You can write, you know, you can do so many different things. And you can do all of this in one book because, like I mentioned, there's 256 characters on a page. And in the book, there is 50 pages. I'll show you the max here. 50 pages in a book. That's absolutely insane how much you can write in this thing. So I'll write here, okay, and that is the end of the story. You know, just hypothetically, I've written a 50-page epic novel in Minecraft. And basically, yeah, once you've written your pages and you've checked over it, because you can check over again, you press sign. What this does is it gives you the opportunity to, you know, like, give the book a title. This will be kind of binding unless you use an anvil, so make sure you pick a good one. So this is going to have the best title ever, which will be Cats. So now I've signed my book, Cats, and as you can see, the book and quill changes from a book and quill to what looks like an enchanted book. It has the exact same, you know, kind of animation and effect as an enchanted book, and you can see it's just there. But it isn't actually an enchanted book, it's just my book called Cats. So now anyone can look through that and they can read. Welcome to best server, rules don't grieve, and then they can see all the separate things, and that's pretty cool. So, of course, reading this won't be done with this. It'll probably be done like left trigger, right trigger, or maybe with the D-pad, but it's still a pretty cool concept for the console, because this can be used for so many different cool reasons. So, right now, especially for map makers, this has a lot of use, because you won't have to read signs. You'll be able to just read it here in order, and if, you know, the sign formatting on consoles is just all over the place and messy, and it's just not a good way to read, whereas this, if you just see, it's just so easy to read. It's written in a way that makes it easy to read, and that's great. And that's not where this guide ends, however. So as well as being able to have 50 pages of 256 characters, which is a lot to write with, what you can do is the cool thing about book and quills is they make duplicatable books. So if you need to have a book for everyone who joins the server, you don't have to have like a corner of people who sit there writing up your book over and over again. What you can actually do is if you go to the crafting table again on console, this will be slightly different. All you have to do is surround your original book by books and quills. You can do it in any formation you want to do. You can go in like an X formation, you can do whatever you want. But yeah, what it'll actually do is it'll give you copies of the original right there. So what you can actually do is you can get copies of your book. So it will say that it's a copy. People will know that they don't have the original, but it's still a pretty cool, you know, thing right there. So this is the original. These are the copies. And now everyone on my server can be handed a copy of Cats. So yeah, like I said, this is really cool if you have a server or, you know, a world where you're inviting lots of people. And I think if servers do come to console, this is a small hint at that because these do make a lot of sense in servers. I think it's a pretty cool possibility. I think it's if you have any multiplayer functionality in your world and you want to tell people stuff, you need to have these. If you just have a multiplayer map, you invite people to still have one of these rather than using signs. It's going to really change a lot of the way the game works. And if you want to know, is it going to be really painful to write them? For the most part, yes. But if you want to make it easier as to, you know, how you write in these books, what you want to just do, or what you have to do, is either use the Smart Glass app. It's an app where you can use your phone as a keyboard for your Xbox, or you can plug in a USB keyboard to your Xbox 360. I think that's the PS3 and maybe the PS4 on the Xbox One too. I'm not entirely sure, but yeah, you can actually plug in USB keyboards. If not, on the 360, there is a chat pad. There's a bunch of different opportunities that you can write with. And if you want to write a lot of books, if you do a lot of multiplayer maps, I would recommend investing in one of those things I just mentioned. Either way, I hope you enjoyed the video. Please do like it if you did like it, share it if you really liked it, and subscribe if you're new around here. I do feature previews like this every time they announce a feature, as long as it's like a reasonable feature. And if you want to subscribe and see more feature previews and other just various Minecraft stuff, you can subscribe and do that. If you want to check out the rest of the playlist, I'll leave a link somewhere in the annotations to all of the feature previews so far, if you want to know about all the features we have confirmed so far. And besides that, I'll see you all in the next video. We'll be right back.